double good. Come on and double it. Doublemint, Doublemint gum.
There's no single gum like it.
This Saturday, make a date with the gang from Beverly Hills. Catch a special presentation of 90210 right after Cops Saturday.
Hi, everybody. I'm Kris Long. Up next on Fox News Chicago on this Thursday, searching for answers down in Texas. Was the man responsible for killing 22 people yesterday a woman hater? We'll have the latest from Killeen, Texas. On Capitol Hill today, a decision on attempting to outlaw weapons like the ones used by the Texas killer. Illinois Democrats tonight are getting together. They don't plan to throw in the towel in 1992. And one of the great good old boy entertainers of all time is dead, Tennessee Ernie Ford. Bruce Wolf of Sports, Dan the Weatherman checks the weekend forecast. Fox News Chicago coming your way next.
Takes me to this very romantic place for a candlelight dinner in his Nissan Pathfinder. We sit at a table for two that has this really nice view.
It's nice to know that Tropicana Pure Premium has only one ingredient, 100% pure oranges, with nothing added and nothing taken away. Because once you know that, it should come as no surprise that no other major brand of orange juice comes closer to this than this. Tropicana Pure Premium. You just can't pick a better juice. Oh, and here's something else you should know. Pure Premium is also available in a 96-ounce container.
These ladies dated the same two men. How did they score?
I beat him. He took his beating very well.
Studs.
Monday through Saturday at 10:30. From WFLD, voted Illinois' best newscast by United Press International, this is Fox News Chicago at 9.
Flags fly at half staff in Killeen, Texas, one day after a gunman goes on a deadly rampage. And in Washington, the House shoots down a proposed ban on semi-automatic weapons like the one used in the Texas massacre. Good evening, everybody. Glad you're with us tonight. I'm Kris Long, Lilia Chacon, sitting in for Robin Robinson.
As residents of Killeen, Texas, try to make sense out of a senseless killing, the House of Representatives has killed a measure that would have banned the type of weapon used by the gunman.
And tonight, investigators say a deep hatred of women may have triggered the bloody rampage by 35-year-old George Henard, a rampage that left 22 innocent people dead. Reporter Mike Capps with the latest.
George Henard lived alone in a stately two-story brick home in a wooded section of Belton, Texas. Police have the home blocked off now. Sightseers pass by to get a glimpse. Neighbors know little about Henard himself.
He came over and asked if we had a repair kit for his bicycle. And he was real nice about it. They talked, and Roy said that he's, talked to him on several occasions.
Ann Hartfield and several other neighbors never believed George Henard was capable of violence or mass murder.
While neighbors don't understand Henard or his anger, they cite two examples of situations that may have upset him. First was a water bill he called excessive. The other was a disagreement over the brick fence surrounding his house.
Neighbors say Henard rebuilt the fence, but remained angry. Basically, they say, he was a loner.
And all he knew is he washed his truck all the time. That was it. And there would be a girl washing a silver car over there. Or he'd be mowing his lawn. That's about the only thing anybody knew, because he wouldn't become friends with anybody.
Sisters Jenna Jernigan and Jill Fritz got a letter from Henard in June. They call it crude, obscene, and hateful toward women, calling women vipers.
My mom had warned us. The funny thing is, she had warned us about a week beforehand that we needed to watch this guy down the street. She had a real funny feeling about him, and that he was weird, and that we needed to watch him. So when we got the letter, I was sort of surprised, but, and then when I read it, I realized really how strange he was, because, it's obvious in the letter he is just completely insane.
By that letter, you could tell exactly what he was capable of. He was crazy. He was nuts.
Anger at women, anger at being unemployed. Still, police have no concrete motive and may never know why George Hennard's anger killed so many people. Mike Capps, Killeen, Texas.
And 11 of those victims are still hospitalized at this hour down in Killeen, Texas, two of them in critical condition.
Despite the carnage in Killeen, the House of Representatives has rejected a ban on 13 different semi-automatic weapons. The ban was tied into a massive crime bill. At least one opponent of that ban changed his mind today.
For me, suddenly the old arguments ring hollow. We hear guns don't kill, people do. Tell that to the victims of those 22 citizens that are dead today.
Though that congressman from Killeen changed his mind, not too many others did. 247 voted against the ban. Only 177 voted for it. One man is dead tonight, another seriously injured after being gunned down in a Southside neighborhood by rival drug dealers in a war over territory. 23-year-old Patrick Warren was found dead in this alley. He'd been shot in the head. The other 28-year-old Ricky Oscar was shot in the chest but was able to run to safety in a two-flat building.
We was going up the steps trying to run because they were shooting, running past. And then he pushed us down the stairs and ran in our room into my sister's room.
The victims were reportedly selling drugs when three men wearing ski masks chased them into the alley and shot them.
Lilia, the Illinois Democratic Party is throwing a party at Navy Pier at this hour. The gathering is a fundraising kickoff to the 1992 presidential campaign. They won't throw in the towel, but it was also a chance to try to get everybody together and see if they can vent some anger at Senator Alan Dixon over his recent support for Supreme Court Justice Clarence Thomas. Al Vaughter standing by live at Navy Pier with more on this. Al?
That's right, Kris. They're trying to deflect some of that criticism. Now, it's only the middle of October, but Illinois Democrats are already kicking off the 1992 presidential campaign season. On hand, two presidential candidates and leaders of a party that is trying to get itself together, although it seems to be pulling apart in all directions. Local women's groups greeted Democrats arriving at tonight's fundraiser, vowing to defeat Senator Alan Dixon next year for his support of Supreme Court nominee Clarence Thomas. Democrats are hoping to raise $250,000 tonight, and most of the big names in the state party are here. But some even bigger names are no-shows, both Illinois Senators Dixon and Simon, and Mayor Daley. Although he's turning his campaign manager over to Arkansas Governor William Clinton to run his presidential campaign. And it was
You've
a joyous event.
Message. It's up to me and all of us who are going to work for you to put the campaign organization together that will enable you to get that very powerful message out to the American people.
We've lost our economic leadership. George Bush knows that. He knows more than half the American people are far worse off than they were when he became president. The only way he can keep a majority is to stir things up, discredit people like Anita Hill, and try to divide the Democrats. I'm not going to let that happen.
Now, the other presidential candidate that is here tonight is Senator Bob Kerry from Nebraska. Two others, Senator Tom Harkin from Iowa and former Massachusetts Senator Paul Tsongas, were no-shows. Speaker of the House Tom Foley was supposed to be the guest speaker here tonight, but some kind of disaster, a fire in Washington, forced him to cancel at the last minute. Now, if you're wondering why Illinois is so important, tomorrow the presidential season officially kicks off here when presidential candidates begin circulating their petitions for next March's presidential primaries. Reporting live from Navy Pier, Al Waters, Fox News, Chicago.
All right, Al, thank you very much.
A political rematch is underway in Chicago's 2nd Congressional District. For the third time, Mel Reynolds is running against incumbent Gus Savage. Reynolds announced his candidacy today in front of a foreclosed home on East 77th Street.
What we've had in the 2nd Congressional District is a decade of decay. Look around as you drive through this community on 75th Street, on 79th Street, and you see nothing.
Reynolds is an attorney. He got more than 43% of the vote in his bid to unseat Savage last year.
Well, the presses are still rolling at the Chicago Sun-Times tonight after union employees this evening reached a tentative contract agreement with the newspaper. After 2 days of talks, the paper's 245 editorial workers gave tentative okay to a 3-year contract, which freezes their pay during the first year and offers small hikes after that. The guild membership will vote on the contract tomorrow. Negotiators for Chicago teachers and the Board of Education are saying now they may be inching toward possible compromise after talks were held today. The union offered cost-cutting proposals of their own after rejecting a board plan. The board's now looking it all over. The union has already voted to approve a strike starting next month. Negotiations continue next Thursday.
And there are huge smiles on the faces of three Illinois lottery players tonight, since each has won a share of the state's $63 million jackpot. Scott Smith reports.
Illinois lottery players set a record this week, buying more than 16 million tickets in one day. For a few, it paid off. There were three-